Hello everyone, so in this video we are going to see how to design 4:16 decoder using 2:4 decoder. Okay, so this is a common type of problem which is asked in many exams. Okay, so somewhat tricky question paper if the examiner want to set, then he will select the type of problems something like this. Okay, so where we need to use some logic in order to implement the design. Alright, so everyone will be knowing 2:4 decoder. Okay, but how to use that 2:4 decoder in order to create 4:16 decoder is the key feature here. Okay, so how we can use this 2:4 decoder is just basically a half adder. It's something like using the half adder to create full adder, 2-bit adder, 3-bit adder, 4-bit parallel adder, carry look ahead adder and carry subtract adder. So okay, so these type of designs are also asked, but in case of encoder decoder these type of problems are generally asked where they want to implement us a bigger decoder with the help of small decoder. Okay, so in this case we want to implement 4:16 decoder using 2:4 decoder. Alright, so by seeing this problem I come to know that for my design there are 4 inputs, okay, so and 16 outputs, total I want 16 outputs and 4 inputs. So what I will do, I have to use 2:4 decoder where there will be 2 inputs and 4 outputs. So with the help of one decoder, that is 1:2 decoder, I can get 4 outputs. Okay, so what I will do, I need 16 total, so how many I will use, 4. So here one, if I use 1:2 decoder, I am getting 1, 2, 3, 4 outputs. I will use another 1:2 decoder, I will get another 4, so I will get up to 7. So I will use another one, then I will be getting up to 11, then I will use another one, so then I will be getting up to 15. So I have got 16 outputs here. Okay, so how I have got 16 outputs, I am using 2:4 decoder 4 times, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, so this is how we should calculate how many times I should use the 2:4 decoder. So suppose if it is 5 to 32 bit decoder, so I want total 32 outputs. So what I will do, if I am using 4 outputs I will be having. Okay, so okay, so it should be 5 to power 36. Okay, so if I want to implement it, so 6 times I will be calling 2:4 decoder, so 6 4 is 36. Okay, so 5:36 I can implement by calling the 2:4 decoder 6 times. So if I want to implement 5:30, then 4 into 6 times, okay, 6 times I can use this one. Alright, so depending on the combination I can increase the number of 2:4 decoders here. So if the output number of lines will increase, then I need to use more number of 2:4 decoders. So coming to our example now, I want to implement here 4:16, so I will select these 4 2:4 decoders, then give same input for the all 2:4 decoders, that is first lower bits. So we are having A0, A1, A2 and A3, these are the 4 inputs. Okay, so give these lower LSB and this is MSB, right? So give the LSB bits common to all the decoders. Okay, so A1, A0, A1, A0, A1, A0. So we know that decoder is having another input, that is enable. So this is the enable input which is given. So the main work here is the enable. So depending on the enable state only, the different types of 2:4 decoders will be selected here. Okay, so now you have got the idea that we need to give same LSB bits for the all 2 to 4 decoders. That is first thing. In the next thing, use another one. So why I am using this one is I want to activate, so if enable pin is equal to 1, then only the particular decoder 2 to 4 decoder will be activated. So if it is 1 for this one, then it is activated and all others will be off or deactivated. Alright, so that's why I am using enable pin here. It is active high means whenever the enable value is 1, then the particular 2 to 4 decoder for which it is connected will be on and others will be off. So the work of 2 to 4 decoder is that depending on the input combinations A3 and A2, only one of these outputs will be high at a time. So that's why when one of its input is output is high, one of these 2 to 4 decoder will be high. So that's why we will be getting only one output at the end as high, others as zero. Okay, so that's why when this one is high, this will be get activated. When N1 is high, that is this pin is high, this will get activated. When N2 is high, this will get activated, and when N3 is high, the last one will get activated. Okay, so depending on the sequence which is applied here, again the output is selected here. Okay, so let me take an example of A3, A2, A1, A0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Alright, so all the bits are 0 for my input. So first A3, A2. So this is 0, 0 combination. And enable, assume this is connected to enable is equal to high. So for this one. So I have given 0, 0 here. So when 0, 0 is given, the what decoder will do? N0 pin it will select. So the output will be high for N0, that is 1 will be here and others will be 0. So this is the basic working. If you apply binary, then decimal value will be output. So N0 will be high here. So this one is high means, so it will go here and this one is high now. And all others, these are 0. So these 3 decoders will be off and only this will get activated. So now I will see what is the A1 A0 value. A1 A0 value is 0 0 again. So when A1 A0 value is 0 0, then again what it will do? It will select the output to this one, D0, D1, D2, D3, right? So 0 it will select. So it will make this pin as high. That is Y0 is equal to 1. So ultimately what we are getting when applying 0 0 0, Y0 is 0 means 0 we are getting at the output. So like this, so these bits play a important role in selecting the 2 to 4 decoder. Okay, particular 2 to 4 decoder which has to be get activated is selected by the A3 A2 pins. So we will see another condition, that is 1 1 1 1. Okay, in this condition A3 A2 are 1 1, so it will select N3 as high and others will be 0. So N3 is high means this one will be get activated and others will be off. Okay, so this got activated. Now A1 A0 value we have to see, because these are common for every 2 to 4 encoder. Okay, 2 to 4 decoder, sorry. Then A1 A0 value is 1 1 here, so it will not select this. So this will select, so again it will be internally D0, D1, D2 and D3. So it will select this one because A1, A0 value are both 1. So both 1 means 3. So 3 has selected, Y15 will be equal to 1 here. So when all the input combinations are 1, the output decimal value equivalent to 1111 is 15. So like this we can implement 4 to 16. So we are giving 4 inputs here, that is A0, A1, A2, A3, we are getting 16 outputs. So this is how we can create a 4:16 decoder with the help of 2 to 4 decoder. Okay, I hope you found this video useful. Now the truth table is very big for this one, so I will just show you some conditions for the output and input. Okay, so here it is. So these are the A0, A1, A2, A3 are the inputs, and Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3 up to y15 are the outputs. So for 000 only y0 will be high and others will be 0 here. And for 0001 the only y4 value will be high, because this is 00 means first a decoder will get activated, and here it is 01 means the okay, so 01 means y1. Okay, sorry, I have written y4, sorry, y1. So it has to get activate y1 here. It will get activate here and others will be 0. Okay, so because 01 represents 1 in the binary, so that's why 1 will get activated. Okay, so what I am trying to explain is these two bits are 0 means this encoder will be selected, and these two bits are 01. So 01 in decimal is 1. So this y1 will be selected and y1 will be equal to 1 here. So that I am trying to explain. Okay, so this is, and others terms will be 0. So note that at any time only one of the output terms will be high, others will be 0. Okay, now the last condition. So 1111, at that time, as I said, only y15 will be activated or high and others will be 0. Okay, so like this you can have 15 combinations and corresponding outputs. So I have not written all those things. You can fill it up if you want. Okay, so thank you guys. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this video useful. And if you are not subscribed to the channel, please guys do subscribe. Thank you. Thanks for watching.